We get the gist of it. He's saying that his wife, that you did ask people to move, that you did ask them to make regular contributions, ask them to work for you.
Of course. Now, I had a meditation center in San Diego, Los Angeles, and San Francisco. That's true. I've never asked anyone to move anywhere. Sometimes people occasionally switch to a different town or do whatever of their own volition. But that's
I mean, do you
that
have
I
an organization that plans your seminars? Obviously, you must.
No.
You don't sit by yourself. Who makes up the ads?
Okay. Basically, I write all the body copy myself. I design the ads. Harry Langdon takes the pictures. And I have a couple people who I hire to put all the ads together. It's basically a one-man operation.
But there are no followers that you say, come with me to Boston.
Oh, no, of course not. There are individuals who work at a seminar. In other words, someone will do registration. You know, they run the credit card things through and things like that. But that's that. Now, the individual he mentioned was a woman who was a business manager of mine for a while. That's true. I had a business manager for a while. Now I have a big eight accounting firm do it all because it's simpler. But essentially, these accusations...
Sure, what's the rub? How did you... is your wife okay?
Oh, my wife is fine. There's nothing involved as far as
I'm trying to pinpoint here. I mean, it seems such a dichotomy between the guests and the calls and the reports. I mean, I don't understand it.
Oh, no, I'm not here to slander Mr. Freddie Lenz, as far as I'm concerned, can do what he wants. I have no complaints there. I mean, meditation, I think, is a good thing. It's not personally something that I would choose.
But what did your wife... Did your wife complain about him?
Yes, she does.
Saying?
She doesn't say anything about sexual harassment. That isn't... She never mentioned anything like that.
What does she say?
She says that he wanted people to clean his home, to do things like that. He asked people to follow him. They didn't follow of their own free will. In some cases, they did. Some people became dependent upon him. I know one woman who was a friend of hers who is so distraught now, she can't have a relationship with anyone. She feels the need to be with Zen Master
Rama. All right, let's be honest. Do you have a lot of followers who get very attracted to you, who come to every seminar, who are kind of like groupies?
Sure. This happens occasionally, and what has caused some problems is when this has happened, I've asked these individuals not to come to any more seminars. Okay, you have to understand, I'm a professional educator. I'm a university professor. And in the field of religion, sometimes people get very, very enthusiastic. But sometimes they try and make you into somebody or something that you're not. And it's impossible to fulfill everybody's expectations. So there are times when I say, please don't come anymore, because you see a level of fanaticism developing.
And they get distraught.
They get very distraught. And it's inevitable when you deal with thousands of people that there are going to be a handful of people who... You can't please everybody.
Well, there has to be some, a thin line you walk in here. I mean,
yes,
we
there
said
is.
A lot of people do seminars. I mean,
yes.
Guys do seminars and they leave, you know, they do an insurance seminar and somebody doesn't leave Aetna to go work, to follow them across the country.
I understand.
So there's some spirituality, there's some sexuality.
Surely. Well, there's sexuality in that I am a single man, I date women and have for many, many years, and I hope to continue to. So certainly sexuality. I don't think I'm particularly prolific and hopefully discreet. But sometimes there's someone who wants you. When you're up on a stage, it changes everybody's opinion of you.
Yeah.
And suddenly it makes you into something perhaps that you're not for them. And they, when you don't want to go out with them, perhaps they get very upset.
You have no cult group with members.
Of course not.
There's no organization where I could get a list of who's a member of your organization.
Of course not.
To Somerville, South Carolina, with Rama. Hello.
Hello. Good evening, Larry. I'm glad to see you're in good health.
Thank you.
I just wanted to ask Rama if he takes any of the funds that are coming into his organization, you know, say like Jim Baker did, and also if he has had any experiences with, say, prostitutes. He claims to be a religious fanatic, according to
this. Are you religious? Well, hold it. He doesn't claim to be a religious fanatic.
No, I don't think so.
Are you a religious person?
Of course I'm a religious person, in the sense that I think anybody who believes in God is a religious person.
Do you believe in such things as right and wrong?
Certainly.
Sin?
I don't think as we would commonly define it. I mean, that means so many different things to people. It could be the Ten Commandments, it could be whatever. I certainly think that you can, anytime you injure anyone else, that's incorrect.
Do these groups that go and rescue people?
Yes.
Bring them back from their cults, right?
Yes.
Do you know if they go after people who are associated with Jimmy Swaggart?
I really don't know. They seem to go after anybody who has wealthy relatives who will spend $25,000 to $50,000. That seems to be the bottom line. In terms of prostitutes and things like that, let's not be ridiculous. I am not a nonprofit organization. This is a standard seminar business, so of course
you're
I receive
business.
A salary. I'm a
You're
businessman.
Very successful.
Yes, extremely.
You have two Porsches?
Yes, two older Porsches, but yes, they're quite nice.
Have a Learjet?
No, not yet. I hope to in the future.
Rent Goldie Hawn's house?
I did a long time ago, yes, in Malibu.
Make middle triple figures?
Lower.
Lower triple figures.
Yes.
San Francisco, hello. Sort of like an anchorman in
where?
Kansas City, right?
Right.
Okay. Somerville, South Carolina, turn to that. Oh, I'm going now, sorry. San Francisco, hello.
Yes, I'm in a very technically oriented field. I'm an engineer. I'm wondering if people like myself can benefit from the study of Zen Buddhism. And if so, is the study of meditation consistent with the pursuit of technical careers such
as...
Good question. Yes, in my experience, computer science, technical careers, along with the liberal arts, but particularly the mindset in Zen Buddhism that one develops is a complete concentration focus. We do lots of exercises and advanced mental development exercises. This is primarily what I teach. And a lot of the individuals who come to seminars are programmers, systems analysts, and I found a tremendous correlation, yes, between Zen and focus and mental development.
So in other words, dealing with a lot of technical data,
yes.
If he honed and perfected that, he would be better.
He would be much better at what he did. This is mainly what I deal with. This is how to hone and develop the mind to a fine point and also to have fun with it.
So it doesn't just have to be artistic?
Oh, no, of course not.
In fact, maybe more of an edge to the technical.
Most of the people who come to my seminars are technical people.
San Diego, hello.
Hello, Mr. King.
Yes.
I was a former student of Rama's back in 1982 when he was known as Atmandana. And I can tell you that he is a potential Jim Jones, a very, very dangerous man. And I also know that all of these claims that have been made by his former students are true. And I have not heard one word of truth uttered by his mouth.
Let me ask you something. Did he ask you to live in a place with a whole group of other people?
No, he did not.
Right. Did he say to you, you must come to the next meeting or something would happen to you?
No.
Ask you to leave your family? I'm sorry, what did he do to harm to you?
What did he do that harmed me?
Mm-hmm.
I experienced personality changes that nearly destroyed my life.
My family. Did he force you or did this happen while you were at a seminar?
This was under mind control.
He individually took control of your mind?
Individually and massively. It was happening to all of us.